This round, I just want to see heavy punches. Let it go. Good job. You're listening perfectly. Nice work. Oh, wow. That punch damaged me, right? That's what we need. Power. Here goes. Nice, 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 nice punch. Yes, she felt that one, right? Okay. Come on, 30 seconds left. Yeah, that's it. Work on that boxing damage. Here we go. Ready? Let's go. Now that's the aggression I want to see in your next fight. Great job. Great job. All right, let's get in there and move. Control! Great job in there. Your timing is really on point. Yes! Hold her down, that's right. Come on, 30 seconds left. Great job. That's what I want to see. Time for some grappling. We're gonna take it easy and flow between positions until we find the submission. All right, let's work. Great job in there. Your timing is really on point. Work. Keep working. Let's transition. Good job. Yes, submission is close. Hey, submission is close. Keep pushing. Come on, 30 seconds left. All right, let's push the pace on her. Nice work. Lock her down. Some nice transition. For the takedown. Once you get on top, control her. Use your weight and pin her to the mat. Good, good. She can't get you down. Oh, that combo was tight. More of that. Let's go. Now that's the aggression I want to see in your next fight. Great job. Beautiful combination. Uh-huh, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. Put the pressure on her. Let's go. Don't stop now. 20 seconds left. Nice! Your wrestling base is getting stronger. Now let's keep drilling. Jiu-jitsu literally translates into the gentle art, because you can neutralize any opponent with a choke or joint submission without having to throw any strikes. So let's get out there and be gentle. Nice work controlling her and getting yourself out. Great control. We gotta make something happen. Let's go. Seconds. Let's go. Hey, good job finding a way out of that. There we go. There we go. Position before submission. I like it. Hey, no excuses today. It was a bad day. Okay, I want you to push today. Give it everything you got. Let's go. Nice timing on that takedown. Here we go. Let's hold her down here. That's where you're winning. Awesome combo. That's what we want. Don't stop now. 30 on the clock. I love it. She's got nothing against your takedowns. Let's go. All right, some sweet science. Let's go. Yeah, that's it. Work on that boxing damage. I love it. Nice strikes. That'll keep her honest. Make it happen. Beautiful combination. Yes, keep it up. Put the pressure on her. 30 seconds. Let's go. Hey, don't worry about today. Tomorrow is gonna be a lot better.
All right, coming up next, it is our main event, a matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight title. All right, here's the number one women's bantamweight contender. She believes for a while she's been the best at 135 pounds. She's making the walk tonight, staring down the champion. Confidence, not an issue. Fear, not a factor. We'll see if this talented number one contender can shed that label and leave with a new one as the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. Well, this belt has changed hands quite a bit, but not since it's been held down by this young woman. the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World. She has really set the standard for excellence at 135 pounds. Tonight, though, facing a number one contender that comes in with a lot of momentum. So if she can defend the belt yet again here tonight, it would really go a long way in stamping her legacy as one of the greatest bantamweight fighters and champions of all time. Our tale of the tape for this, our main event of the evening. More than a decade separates these two fighters when it comes to the age, with similar height and some differences in reach. All right, now for the official introductions, we go inside the octagon to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. When the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean. Now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Bell Center in Montreal, Quebec, Canada, it's time! Five rounds for the undisputed UFC Championship of the World. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner.
This woman is a jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 15 wins, 9 losses.
She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of Chicago, Illinois, presenting the challenger, Juliana, the Venezuelan Vixen Pena. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner.
This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 37 wins, 1 loss.
She stands 5 feet 5 inches tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of New York, New York, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, King.
All right, this is for the championship. You can give me your instructions in the dressing room. Protect yourself at all times. Follow my instructions. We will have a clean fight. Touch gloves is not necessary.
So round one is underway. After her last fight, you heard Bruce Buffer say, and still UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She is trying to have him say it again here tonight. She is unquestionably the number one 135-pound fighter in the world. She has successfully defended this belt in the past, and she believes here tonight she's on a different level than the number one contender. We'll see if she can prove it here and turn those words into actions as round one gets underway. Pena gets in the clinch. Let's see if she can use her length now.
Look at the control and the posture as that big knee lands.
Well, you asked her on Thursday, how soon are you going to shoot? Very early. Nice job getting the fight to the ground here in the early game. Looks like she's trying to set up a submission now. Long on grappling experience coming into the UFC, and you see her chops here, just beautiful when it comes to the transition.
It's very difficult to keep up with her on the ground.
Well, her opponent is squirming, and this might be the beginning of the end. The ground and pound strikes continue to land at will.
She's landing him over and over again. She needs to make sure that when she's chasing the finish, she doesn't get excited and lose the position. There it is.
This might just be a matter of time. And that will do it!
Toller, oh my goodness! What a performance!
Yeah, no doubt about it. That is some up opportunistic grappling right there, and nice finishing instincts as well. You see a lot of fighters get the dominant position, but aren't necessarily able to lock up the choke or force the tap. No problem with her as she gets one of the bigger wins of her UFC career. So there she is as the celebration continues in the corner. The queen of the 135ers, the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion, your winner tonight by way of submission. What a way to get the job done and leave with the UFC gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 56 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by tap out.
Israel Adesanya, she doesn't hope and pray. She aims and fires, and she is still the UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion.
What a great champion that rules atop this division. She's the queen of the world in one of the UFC's best women's divisions.
Thank you.
I want to see your skills right now. Let's get in there and push. Oh, good block. Great job in there. Your timing is really on point. Yes. Let me see those combinations. Good job. Nice punch. Yeah, nice punch. She felt that one. Huge punch. I like it. That must have hurt. You got this. 20 on the clock. Great job in there. I can already... Okay, I want you to push today. Give it everything you got. Let's go. Well done. Nice defense. Now, 30 on the clock. Beautiful job. No worries. We'll get better. Let's show up tomorrow. Today, I want to see you sharp and quick. Oh, nice! Really impressed with your performance today. Great job. There we go. Soften her up. Yes, like that. Keep going. Nice work in there. Nice. Let's go. 30 on the clock. Thank you. Nice. Your wrestling base. My clock doesn't stop until you submit her. Let's go. There you go. Nice work. Lock her down. Ooh, that was pretty good. All right, let's push the pace on her. Nice work. Lock her down. We've got 30 seconds. Let's go. Good money. Hey, no excuses today. It was a bad day, but don't worry about it. Okay, I want you to push today. Give it everything you got. Let's go. That's it. That's the way you put her on her back. Come on. Scramble there. That's how you throw a combination. Awesome stuff. Here we go. Awesome job. Let's move on. Nice work in there. Nice. Let's get after it. And 30 to go. Great. Job. okay, not bad, not bad. We'll do. My clock doesn't stop until you submit her. Let's go. Come on, let's work there. Stay busy! Set up your pass. Dominated today. Good work. Hey, you're doing great. Don't stop now. 20 seconds left. That's what I like to see. You kept. Listen for my instructions, all right? Let's go! You dominated today! Good work! Work! Kid, work! Work! That was some good work in there. Again, drillers make killers. Don't stop now, you got 30 seconds.
coming up next, the matchup for the UFC Women's Bantamweight Division title. Well, this is a belt that has changed hands quite a bit, and this number one bantamweight contender believes it will again here tonight as she makes the walk for this title fight. She believes this title shot should have come earlier. She's not caught up in all that now, hasn't been during fight week. She's focused on the champion, and you see her staring her down right now. Crowd going crazy. She believes she is the best bantamweight in the world and believes in a matter of moments here, she will be the new champion. Well, this belt has changed hands quite a bit, but not since it's been held down by this young woman, the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the world. She has really set the standard for excellence at 135 pounds. Tonight, though, facing a number one contender that comes in with a lot of momentum. So if she can defend the belt yet again here tonight, it would really go a long way in stamping her legacy as one of the greatest bantamweight fighters and champions of all time. Our tale of the tape for this women's bantamweight championship fight. Both fighters are 35 years old, with some differences in height, but big differences in reach. And now for the official introductions, the veteran voice of the Octagon is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the Octagon, Eve Loving. Now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out Madison Square Garden Arena in New York City, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC bantamweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter, holding a professional record of 15 wins, 11 losses. She stands 5'1" tall, weighing in at 134 pounds. Presenting the challenger, Neha. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 38 wins, one loss. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in at 135 pounds. Fighting out of New York, New York, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion of the World, King.
UFC belt on the line. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
The fighters touch him up.
Ready?
All right, so round one is underway. After her last fight, you heard Bruce Buffer say, and still, UFC Women's Bantamweight Champion. She is trying to have him say it again here tonight. She is unquestionably the number one 135-pound fighter in the world. She has successfully defended this belt in the past, and she believes here tonight she's on a different level than the number one contender. We'll see if she can prove it here and turn those words into actions as round one gets underway. Oh, strong series of kicks by her there. It's almost like she throws her feet as if they're two more hands.
I mean, that is crazy. Use every weapon available, and she is using her kicks as her main weapon.
Well, she's able to connect on the punch there, DC, really making good use of her reach advantage.
Oh, man.
Landed a big kick there. Massive head kick.
That one is off. Can't take pictures now. She has to react. She has to chase the finish.
Is downright scary, in constant pursuit of the finish. Might get it here.
She does a really good job of throwing punches with intent. She never.
Wow! Wow!
Oh! Woo!
Not sure she could have drawn it up much better. Just a beautiful strike to end the fight for her opponent, who candidly may not have even seen that flush shot coming. So this is exactly the way she drew it up. She told us during fight week that she had to find a way to finish this fight, to send a message to the rest of this division. Message sent. All right, let's go inside the octagon now to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 30 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, and still the undisputed UFC bantamweight champion of the world,
Hey! All right, so she will head home the way she arrived as the undisputed UFC bantamweight champion as she gets it done by knockout here tonight. She was so dismissive of this challenger, and maybe with this result, you see as to why.
I mean, when you start to put so many title defenses together, you start to see that. But don't think for a second she does not prepare herself as she did when she was just a challenger also. She is a phenomenal fighter. She is a champion in every form of the word, and she's going to continue to reign atop this division for as long as she possibly can.
Yeah. Okay. J'ai fait mes gammes dans la street, je suis validé. J'assume mes actes, pas du genre à me défiler. On sait comment faire des billets, je veux pas les nier. Heureusement, c'est putain de segment pète. Cette machine a fait constamment ton autre idée. mais mon poids m'a pigé. Rentrons dans le vif du sujet. Faut pas s'étonner du rejet. Dans les quartiers défavorisés, il va falloir augmenter le budget. Cette manière de s'en mettre dans les poches. L'impression d'avoir loupé le coche. La politique a son apogée. Ils vont nous en mettre plein les yeux. Promettre mon émerveil à la banque.